Hello everyone, welcome to Spring Boot OAuth security course. In this video, I am going to teach you how to handle the CORS support in Spring Boot OAuth security. In this demo, I am going to show you how to enable the cross-origin resource sharing for the authorization server and resource server. I hope you guys are seeing my previous videos such as how to develop the authorization server and how to develop the resource server. If you guys are not watched those videos links given in the description section, please go through that. After you completing the authorization server and the resource server development, then you can come to this video. In this video, I am going to explain you step by step how to add the CORS support for authorization server and how to add the CORS support for resource server. Response for preflight does not have the HTTP OK status. This response you will get when you call the APIs such as authorization server token API or any resource server APIs. You will get this error in the web application console. And then the no access control allow header is present on the requested resource. This error also you will get in the web application, the browser console, when you integrate with your web application into the authorization server and resource server. Why these errors are getting in the web browser console? Basically, you are running an application in different ports. For example, authorization server is running on localhost :8080 port, and then resource server is running on the localhost 8000 port, and then your web application is running on the 9090 port. So in this case, you are trying to access the resource from the different port. For example, your application, the web application is running on the localhost 9090, then by using a JavaScript or jQuery, you are calling a resource API or any token API for the authorization server. Those APIs are running on the different port. So the web browser will not allow you to access these resources. Basically, this issue is not depends on the browser. This issue should basically like your authorization server or resource server does not allowing those resources to the different port. So how to enable this? So basically these changes you have to do in the server side, not from the client side. Now I am going to show you how to enable the CORS support for the authorization server. Already authorization server, resource server, and then the web application is running on my machine on the different ports. First I will show you how to get the authorization server token and then how to access the resource server APIs by using those tokens. In that request headers, the response headers, you can't see the access control allow header request response headers. Okay, so basically if you are not getting those response headers, the web browser will not allow you. This red alert, the response for preflight does not have the HTTP OK status and no access control allow header is present on the requested resource. These two steps also I will show you. After that, we will enable the authorization server CORS support and resource server CORS support. Then we won't get these red alerts. Okay. The first step, I would like to show you the getting a token and accessing the resource API and these errors from the web browser console. Already authorization server, resource server and web application is running on my machine. Now I will show you the how to get the token and then how to access the resources. Those who are watched my previous video how to develop the authorization server, they can know about how to get the token by using Spring Boot OAuth 2 security. So now I am getting a OAuth token here. Okay, so look at here, the authorization server is running on the 8080 port. Now I am going to the headers. You can see there is no access control allow header in the response headers. Okay, so same wise, I am going to access the resource server APIs get list of permissions by using a new token. I can able to see the list of permissions here, but look at the response headers. There is no access control allow origin header. And also same wise, by using a refresh token, I am getting an access token. Okay, so look at here. I have a refresh token here. By using this refresh token, I am trying to get a new access token. This request also, I mean the response also, don't have any headers like CORS enabled, like access control allow origin header. Okay. Now I am going to get this OAuth token by using web application. We will get an error. So now I will show you that. Look at here. This is an application running on the 9090 port. Now I am giving my email address and then the password. After clicking a login button here, the request will go to the 8080 port OAuth token API. Okay, I am sending my username and password and grant type, everything by using a JavaScript. Okay, but I can't log in. So look at your incorrect email address or password. Here I am providing a common error message if any issues happen in the login screen. Now I am going to show you that what error we will get it in the browser console. Look at here, in the browser console, we got this error. Response for pre-flight does not have the HTTP OK status. Okay. Failed to load the resources, the server responded with the status 401. So basically, this OAuth token API. So look at here, this OAuth token API is not allowing to access the resources from the different port 9090. Okay. Now I am going to enable the CORS support for the authorization server first step. Already authorization server is running on my machine. Now I am going to create a class called simple CORS filter. Those who have watched my video, the previous videos how to develop the authorization server, they can easily understand this concept. Okay, now I am going to enable the authorization server. Enable the CORS support for the authorization server. Now I am going to add this annotation. This class will act as a component class, and also this class should be the highest precedence of order. Okay. So here also I am adding the ordered annotation. So basically this simple CORS filter is nothing like a servlet filter. Okay. This class I am going to implement the filter. It should be like a simple Java X servlet filter. Okay. You can add the unimplemented methods here. I just created the simple constructor. And then I added the override methods, init method, and then the destroy method. So the main part code, I am going to write it in the filter method. Look at here, I override the do filter method. I'm inputting all the statements. All the input statements. And also this method should throws the IO exception and then the servlet exception. Inside this filter, so whenever the request is coming to the server and then whenever the response is going to the end user or whoever calls that request, this simple CORS filter do filter method will execute. Okay, basically this simple CORS filter act as a interceptor of all the requests. Now I am creating a HTTP servlet request object and then HTTP servlet response object. Okay, so here I am adding a response headers. Access control allow origin is char. This char represents so anybody can access the resources. Otherwise, you can mention the port here. Only this port can access this. Now I am going to provide it as a char. And then what are the access control methods you can access? Post, get, options, delete, and put. And then the maximum age for the access control is 3600 seconds. And then the access control allow headers. What are the headers should accept? So look at here, requested with authorization, and then the content type. Response headers, we can accept it. And then look at here, if the request method is an options, then I am sending a status OK. Otherwise, the chain do filter method will execute. What happened in the sense, if you are running an application into the local host, the options method will call. So the browser will make an options call to access this resource. This options API should return the 200 OK, then you can access the resource. So basically, if you are running a local machine, I mean running an application in the local host, these options will you need to provide. Otherwise, the normal methods, the post, get, delete, put methods will execute. Okay, so basically now we added the access control allow origin headers. I mean the access control allow headers. So in the every response, so whenever the response is going to the client, this simple CRS filter will call, I mean the do filter method will call, and then these headers will be appended into the headers. Okay, the same simple CORS filter, I am going to add it in the resource server also. So look at here, the resource server also is running in my machine. Now I am going to create a same class here. The class name is simple CORS filter. So basically we can just copy this class file and add it in the resource server also. So whenever the request is coming to the application, this simple CORS filter will add, I mean will call, and then whenever the response is going to the client, before going to the client, these headers will be added in the response headers. So now we added this simple CORS filter support in the both authorization server and resource server. Already the resource server is running in my application, I mean in my Eclipse. I just stopped that, and also this is the web application. And then this is the authorization server. Authorization server also I stopped. Now I am going to stop the authorization server application once again now. Okay. And also same wise the resource server also I am going to start now. Resource server application. So basically if you guys are seeing my previous videos such as the authorization server and resource server, you will get familiar to how to run these applications. Okay. So look at here, now I am starting the resource server. Now it's starting, it's taking few seconds, few times. Okay, the application is started. So look at here, web application is running, authorization server is running, and also the resource server application is running. Now I am going to access the APIs. So in the previous request, we did not get any access control headers in the response. Now I am going to get the new token once again from the authorization server. So look at here, in the body section I got the access token, and then in the headers, so look at here, access control allow headers, access control allow methods, origin, access control maximum age, whatever the response headers we added in the CORS filter, we got that. So by using this token, okay, now I am going to access the resource server APIs. In the resource server API also, the previously we did not get the access control allow headers in the response. Now I am going to access the permissions API. So it's checking time. So look at here, in the body section I got the response, and also same in the response headers I got the access control allow headers, access control allow methods, access control allow origin, and access control maximum age. Okay, so we got the access control allow headers in the response. Same ways, by using a refresh token, we need to get the new access token, right? So that API also should return the access control allow headers. So this is the API to get the refresh token. Okay. For this request token also, you have to send the username and password for the basic or the client ID and client secret. And then in the request header, you can add that basic authorization. And then the content type should be the application form URL encoder. And then the grant type should be a refresh token. And then the refresh token, you have to provide the refresh token. So here, previously, we did not get any access control allow headers in the response. Now I am trying to get a new token. I got the new token. And also in the response, we got the access control allow headers, allow methods, allow origin, and maximum age. Okay. Now I am going to show you in the web application. So look at here, previously we got this error. Okay, now we did not get this error. We can access the resources. So look at here, I am just preserving a logs. So look at here. So look at here, we did not get any errors right now. I click the login, but I am getting 400 error. Because invalid grant and then the bad credentials. I given an invalid email address and password. So I got this error. But previously we got the CORS issue, that pre-flight response issue. I mean the error. The error is not coming now. Now I am going to provide a valid email address and then the password here. The valid email address and then the password. I am giving a password. So look at here, now I can able to access the resource APIs also. So look at here in the resource, the permissions, right? This is the permissions API. Here also I did not get any error. I can able to get the all the responses from the resource server also. So look at here, the roles, users, and then the settings. So here also I can able to get all the details from the resource server. This API, this view will be rendered by using by calling a resource server APIs. So while logging, we are getting an access token, but accessing that, after getting an access token, so we are accessing the resource server APIs. Okay. You can find my source code in the GitHub repository. And then thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like my videos, and share my videos. Thank you very much. Goodbye.